Hi! In this video, we're continuing our look at the Java number classes by focusing on the methods that are used to convert our number instance to and from different representations. The Java number classes provide methods to create number instances from primitives. You'll remember from the number autoboxing and unboxing tutorial, valueOf is the main method used to convert primitives to Java number instances.
ValueOf is heavily used for autoboxing and unboxing. We covered ValueOf in depth in the autoboxing unboxing video, so we won't go into depth again. Every example here does the same thing. They create an integer instance with the value 42. This is just the beginning of the Java number conversions available. The first set of Java number conversions methods available to us are methods to convert our integer wrapper class to one of the primitive value types. The most useful conversion method is to convert the class to the matching Java primitive type. In this case, we'd convert an integer to an int. We can also convert the integer to other primitive data types with varying consequences. If you convert the integer class to smaller primitive types, say a short, you're going to cause a narrowing conversion. This is the same narrowing conversion we saw when casting primitives to smaller primitives in the variables video. Converting to larger primitives causes a widening conversion.
We also have methods to convert text to an integer. We would want to do this when we get input from a user, or maybe we're converting strings read from a text file. Text is contained in the string class. Now we're covering the string class in depth after we're done with numbers. For now, just know that a string is a class that represents text. In order to convert text to an integer, we have the decode and parseInt methods. ParseInt is an integer class specific method. If we are working with a long class, the method would be parseLong. It has the same behavior. So let's look closer at these methods.
The decode method takes any number string based on any radix and converts it to an integer instance. In order to determine the correct radix to use, decode expects the string to be formatted in a special way. If the number is a decimal, you can just use the number with no special formatting. However, if the number is a hexadecimal number, the number must start with 0x, 0 capital X, or the pound sign. If the number is octal, it needs to start with a zero. The decode method can handle numbers with a radix of 8, 10, or 16. So what do we use if we have something else, like a binary number? In that case, we need to use the static method parseInt. Again, this method is specific to integers. The long class has parseLong. ParseInt takes two parameters, the number to convert and the radix. In this case, we do not need to format the number text in any special way. The string should just be the number in the correct form. For example, if we need to convert a binary number 101010, we call it like this, and it returns 42. If we used a number string that is not a valid binary number, and then the method will throw a number format exception. In this case, 42 is not a binary number. ParseInt will work for any radix less than or equal to 36. If we use the radix to 36 and then try to convert dog, we will get the value 17,728. However, using the same number and a radix of 4 gives us another number format exception. There's also an overloaded version of ParseInt that takes only one parameter, the number to convert. This method defaults to the radix 10 and expects a decimal number to parse. If we need to convert back to a string, we also have methods for that. There are three static methods on the integer class to convert to a particular radix, to binary string, to hex string, and to octal string. These methods will convert your integer to a string. So if your initial number was minus 42, the string is going to look like this. It works the same for hex and octal numbers. There's also a toString method to output our number to any radix, less than or equal to 36. We can also call toString on instances. This outputs the number contained by the wrapper class as a decimal string. Unsigned integer functions were added in Java 8. This is for the integer and long classes only. An unsigned integer in this context means the number is treated as if the sign bit just adds to the magnitude. So we get bigger numbers, but they're all positive. If we parse this big number as an unsigned int and print it as an integer, we get minus 1. That's because we're still working with a Java int primitive. To get the number as an unsigned integer string, we need to use the method toUnsignedString. To get the number as an unsigned integer string in a different radix, we can use the overloaded method to take the radix as the parameter. It works like the other radix methods.
If you have any questions, add them to the comments below. Next, we'll look at comparing Java number instances. If you enjoy the video, please like the video and share it with your developer friends. You'll also want to sign up for the DGU newsletter. It contains the videos for the month and tips and news not contained in the videos. I'll send that out once a month. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.